requirement. A British purchasing commission in the United States on the lookout for new fighter designs or additional fighters for the Royal Air Force. Selected the backstage still to come North American design over the likes of the already well-proven Curtiss P-40 and how right a decision that proved. When the aircraft took the air and first entered service, it was powered by the Allison V-1710 engine. While it was an excellent airframe and the Allison was a very dependable power plant, the Allison engine 4 was an outstanding mount at low level from the Army Cooperation and photographic reconnaissance roles in particular. The high altitude performance of the early Mustangs wasn't so good. That's where the RAF's Air Fighting Development Unit, then stationed at RAF Duxford in Cambridgeshire, entered the story, and specifically its commanding officer, Ian Campbell Ord. Itself heavily involved in producing Merlins for other uses. So, production for the Mustang was handed over to the American Picard firm. Colonel Don Blakesley. Chinese than any other American fighter pilot. He ended World War II with 15 and a half confirmed kills and a tremendous reputation amongst his fellow Allied fighter pilots. You'll notice this aircraft's lack of any nose art or personal markings. Blakesley wasn't keen on that sort of thing. He used to joke that the C at the end of the aircraft's code letters stood for Chief Cook and Bottle Washer.